Now let's move on to model two, where we're going to build out a decision tree. A decision tree algorithm is quite different than the logistic modeling algorithm. This algorithm analyzes the data as if it was a series of decisions. This results in a comparison between each of the different possible outcomes. In order to illustrate the algorithm, let's use a simple example. I have a full basket of 120 M&Ms at a dinner party. At the end of the night, some have been eaten and some have not. I want to know if I can predict whether a specific M&M will get eaten. Let's get started with only one predictor variable, color. This split would be chosen because it would produce the largest difference in percent eaten between the two groups. Okay, so let's add a second variable, flavor. The only possible split is with or without peanuts. With peanuts is 75% eaten. Without peanuts is 13.3% eaten. Now, if we compare that to color, which split would happen first, color or flavor? Since the flavor has a larger gap, then flavor would cause the first split. Once the first split has happened, each split is treated completely separately. So in order to do the second split, we need to have the full picture of the data. Now let's only consider the peanut groups for the second split and the regular group separately. So how would we use the tree to predict an actual result? So let's say I'm a blue peanut M&M. What is the chance I'm going to get eaten? If we trace along the path for a blue peanut M&M, we can see that at the terminal node, there is a 90% chance of being eaten. And that's the general gist of a decision tree.